Saints, God bless each and every one of you. We are here at Kingdom Faith Ministries once again, and we have these two guests of mine who are frequently on public access with me as well as on YouTube here at Kingdom Faith. You see, we have changed locations, and our broadcast is showing from the sanctuary other than the studio at Channel 18. But nevertheless, we are here with a word from the Lord. And we thank God for Bishop Larry Donald for Greater Trinity. And we thank God for Apostle Clarence Walsh with Franklin from Franklin Powerhouse in Lexington. We thank God for these two men of God. We got a great topic here today. We want to talk about the church and the birthing of the church from the old unto the new.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Prophecy given in Ezekiel.
Okay.
Anything God prophesied is always going to come to pass.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
The birth of the church, and it was spoken, and we're going to get into that, but we're not going to waste a lot of time with this. I'm going to go ahead on and offer prayer so we can break bread. Heavenly Father, right now, I'm so gracious and humble to thank
God.
You for
yes.
your written word.
Yes.
I
yes,
thank
Lord.
You for the living word.
Yes.
I thank you for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
I thank you for the gifts of the
thank
Spirit.
You, Lord God.
I
yes.
thank you for your brand new mercies,
yes.
fresh every
oh,
day,
my
and
God.
Your grace. Father God,
hallelujah.
We thank you for your
thank
ability.
You, Lord.
And we put a demand on your power and presence.
Yes.
Father God, there are people who are listening. We
yes.
got a group that's tuning in.
Yes.
I heard that
yes.
they were being blessed
yes,
and
God.
Empowered by
thank
what
you,
we're
Lord.
Doing.
Hallelujah.
So, Father God, we pray blessings upon
yes.
everyone. We
my
even pray
God.
Healing
yes.
will come
yes.
because some have just had
oh,
surgery.
God.
Who are watching this. And Lord
awesome
God, we
God.
Want to make sure that
glory.
You are glorified and
yes.
lifted up
yes.
in all of this.
Yes.
So,
my
Father God.
God,
right now. When we came
Jesus.
In, your presence is with us.
Yes. Yes.
And if thank your presence God. Here, all of your power
yes.
is here to heal,
yes.
is here
yes,
at
God.
Our disposal.
Yes.
So, Heavenly Father, we humble ourselves.
Yes, yes.
And we
do.
Come under the anointing that is needful for this night
yes, yes,
to deal with who's listening and who need help.
Yes.
Father God, right now. In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
we receive that anointing.
Yes, yes God. Do,
Holy
God.
Spirit, have your
have
way
your
right
way.
Now
thank
in Jesus'
you, Lord.
Name. Amen.
Yes.
We've been dealing with Ezekiel. We was dealing with Ezekiel 34.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about how he said, you have not healed the disease. You have not strengthened the disease. You have not healed the sick.
Right.
You mm-hmm. have not bound up that which is broken. Now, let's fast forward to the New Testament church. Bishop, and we all have said this one time or another, that preaching is meeting the needs of the people.
Mm-hmm. Yes, my Lord.
If we're not meeting the needs of the people, right here, God is displeased because the shepherds
right.
were not meeting the needs of the flock.
Right. Right, right.
The great uh-huh. shepherd had a problem with this.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, something was given and God gave a warning to these shepherds. He gave a warning here. But now we're gonna fast forward to 36.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're gonna Bishop, I think you started reading at 19, if I'm not mistaken, mm-hmm. last time. I scattered them among the heathens. I think mm-hmm. you started at 18, or 19, one of them. You don't have it marked, but we're going to go to the 36, the future restoration of Israel. Now, God is talking about doing something for his namesake.
Uh-huh.
We look bad right now. Apostle.
Yes, yes, yes.
The church is closed.
Mm-hmm.
People are afraid.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been fouling in God's house Sunday, whatever your study Bible night is. We have prayer on Tuesday. We
right.
we come in and we do intercessory prayer
mm-hmm.
for people. And everything is pretty much the same here. And I know at your house,
right.
where you reside and at
man.
Your house,
Yes.
But our co-laborers, we are men of God, and we in this together.
Right. Yes.
We're not singling anybody
That's
out.
Right. That's
so
right.
So you who are listening, we are not putting ourselves above any man of God. But we understand what God is calling for.
Right.
This is the platform we got going on. We understand that some repentance got to go on here.
Amen. Yes.
But
yes.
We're going to look at Ezekiel 36, and we're going to fast forward to 37 to see how the church is supposed to be functioning.
Right.
And with the Holy Spirit, how powerful the church is supposed to be with corona and any other disease
yes.
that's Amen. Going on.
Amen.
Bishop.
Ezekiel 36, you want 18 or 19?
You can start at 18.
18 says, "So I poured out my wrath on them for the blood which they had shed on the land, and because they had defiled it with their idols." 19 says, "Also I scattered them among the nations, and they were dispersed throughout the countries.
Mm-hmm.
I judged and punished them in accordance with their conduct and their idolatrous behavior." Mm. Am I in the right place?
Yeah, yeah, you're okay. In the right place. Now well, that's the other side of God. God is so merciful and so gracious. Now we finna talk about, we done heard enough about how good God is and how loving he is. Now right. We need to flip the coin over and get the wrath side of God.
Amen.
We're going to talk about Amen. That tonight because,
right.
See, you want to say the devil doing this. Devil ain't behind all this stuff. Go ahead, Bishop.
20. When they came to the nations, wherever they went, they profaned my holy name, because it was said of them, "These are the people of the Lord." Yet they have come out of his land.
Okay. Come on.
But I had concern for my holy name.
And his name, he got concern right now. This is why we know revival is on the horizon.
Yes. Oh.
This is why we can take confidence and know God is going to do something. But who's going to be bold enough? Let me say this so you can finish reading and get apostle in there. Who's going to be bold enough to stand in his stead so the revival can begin? This is where we at right now. I know this from an unction inside of me that we are on the horizon in the midst of this pandemic. What better time for God to show himself, because his name is on the line. Go
yes.
ahead, Bishop.
Lord, but I had concern for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the nations where they went.
Come on.
Keep going?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I am about to act, but for my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations where you went.
So I say to kingdom faith.
Oh, God.
To the house of kingdom faith.
Yes.
Now, I ain't going to leave this back in B.C.
Come on.
I'm not leaving
Come
this
on.
In B.C.
Come on.
I'm bringing it. At AD now, I'm bringing it after the death of Christ.
Yes.
He's talking to me that I may warn the house of this house.
Yes.
Amen.
Your house, Bishop.
Amen.
Right.
So now we got to move on. What verse did you?
I stopped at 22.
Now, can we jump? I hate to do this, but we need to get on at, we got to get 23, 24, 25.
Okay.
Come on.
23 says, I will vindicate the holiness of my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, which you have profaned among them. Then the nation will know without any doubt that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when I prove myself holy among you in their sight.
Come
That's
on.
23.
Okay, give me 24.
24. For I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you into your own land. 25, then I will sprinkle clean water on you.
Yes.
And you will be clean.
Okay.
I will cleanse you from all your uncleanliness and from all your idols.
Oh, false okay. worship. So now, Apostle, I know you're itching to get in there. I'm going to let you go. We're going to take the bridle. Go ahead.
Men of God, as Bishop was reading, and what kept jumping out at me was my name, for my name's sake. A preacher told me, says, I'm not opening my house because I don't want my people to come in and get sick. And I say, your people. I said, these are not your people.
Right.
These are God's people. And the house of God has been dedicated to God.
Amen.
And in the book of Jude, he said, now unto him that's able to keep us from falling.
Yes, right.
Now, if we believe that God is able and God can keep us from falling, it's not us that's on trial.
Come on now.
It is God's on trial. It's God on trial. But you got to have faith in God and in the word of God. It's God. It's not up to us to keep the people.
No, no.
It is God that is keeping the people. The Mississippi Mass Choir had a song saying, it's God that's keeping me. It's God that is keeping the people. His name for his name's sake. And the people here in America have defiled the name of God by all kind of wickedness, just like the children of Israel
yes.
had done throughout the land where they had been scattered. And the people, they had defiled the name of God among the heathen.
Yes.
And God was sick of it. He said, now, for my name's sake. And as we get into the Ezekiel, where we're going to go with 37, we're going to find out something about God's, what he'll do for his name's sake. Uh-huh. Go ahead.
So I heard you say it is God who is keeping the people.
Right.
So to me, it seems as if God can keep us at Walmart, but he can't keep us in the house
yes,
of God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you mean to tell me God can't keep us where his name is supposed to be.
Oh, my God.
But he can keep us in a grocery store or a shopping mall that don't even recognize him.
Jesus. But, Apostle, let me say this to add on to what Bishop just got to saying. And right now, we are getting ready, and they're still talking, throwing it out there about the schools and sending the children to school. I got to hit on this again. Because any parent that don't have enough faith to go to the house of God themselves and sit in the house of God a few hours and worship God and gonna sit at home in the privacy of their home and send their child out into this classroom and gonna force them to go and say it's all right for them. Don't you know something is wrong with that picture?
Yes.
Don't you know something is wrong with that?
And the
church, apostle been saying it, bishop been saying it, I've been saying it, we all been saying it. The church, hallelujah, is looking real bad right now. And we are crying, talking about the church is in my heart. I can worship God. Then stop saying that now because you're tired of looking at Facebook. You're tired of looking at
Amen.
The TV
Amen.
And watching the ministers on TV. Now your soul is longing for the fellowship of the saints. I stopped by a store on the way here. And a lady saw me. She said, where you headed? I said, I'm headed to Kingdom Faith Ministries. She said, please, please, pray for me. Call my name. Pray for me. My family. I need God. Blackman was the last name. I don't know the first name.
Okay.
Can't remember. But I said I was going to tell Apostle to make sure that he called that name.
No, you call it and you go ahead on and send the prayer.
Oh, my God.
Go ahead right now.
Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of
Amen.
Jesus
Amen.
Christ, our Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God, you the great I am, the Alpha and
Hallelujah.
The Omega, the beginning and the ending, the first and the last. You are he that was dead but alive forevermore.
Yes.
Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for the word of God. I thank you for the faith that you have given us as we stand in unity. You said, if any two shall agree on earth as touching anything they shall ask of you, it shall be done by you in heaven. Two or three gathered together in your name, that you would be a God in the midst.
Yes,
right now, in the name of Jesus, this sister and her family, Sister Blackman, Lord God, right now in the name of Jesus, I speak peace to her mind. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I speak peace to her family. Lord God, when the enemy comes like a flood, let your Holy Ghost raise the standard and fight in her behalf. Protect her and her family. And not only her, all of those that are out in internet land that are in fear. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, have your way. Mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen and amen.
Amen. Jesus. Apostle, thank you for that.
Yes.
She spoke to you and you released it, and I agree with it.
Yes.
God. Now I'm like you, Bishop and Apostle. The anointing is so strong in Walmart, but it's so weak.
Jesus.
You got more faith in physical things,
my God,
tangible things, than you do the unseen
realm. Oh.
So I understand, because maybe because of your leader and not picking at him, but when you can send your child to school and they talking about they trying to figure out how they're going to have school, they trying to figure out how they're going to do football, but everybody's showing up with COVID, everybody coming in being tested, got it.
Yes.
Ain't gonna be no. I said this in March. It's not gonna be a football.
Yes, yes.
Ten of the I believe said we not having it.
Yeah,
right.
The school, the colleges, they know. I'm telling you, God is not going to let these idols.
Come on.
We talked about how these idols had messed up God's people. Football is an idol.
Yes.
Basketball is an idol.
Come on.
I watch basketball.
Yep.
I watch football.
Yes.
But I got God in His proper place.
Yes.
I'm not missing service and going home to prepare for a Super Bowl.
Come on here.
You got folks who are missed service talking about, I'm going to the Superdome. But church is in my heart, but you're in the Superdome on Sunday.
Got the church.
You were doing that before the pandemic comes.
Yes.
So I understand what you're saying. I go to Walmart. I come to church. I come to God's house. It's anointed here. Wherever I am, God is there.
Come on now.
We take God with us.
Amen.
That's it.
So with that being said, this is prophecy, what God is going to do.
Yeah.
Yes.
This prophecy has been fulfilled, is it not?
Yes.
All right, now, Bishop, I want you to keep reading, and I'm going to tell you when to cut. Then we're going to fast forward to 37. Go ahead.
Let's see. I stopped at 25.
Okay.
Okay. 26 says, moreover, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you.
Okay.
And I will remove the heart of stone from your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you will keep my ordinances and do them. You will live in the land that I gave to your fathers, and you will be my people, and I will be your God.
Okay.
29 says, and I will also save you from all your uncleanness, and I will call for the grain and make it abundant, and I will not bring famine on you.
Okay. All right. Now, this is prophecy spoken for God's people.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, in the 37th chapter is where it's showing a spiritual picture of Israel.
Okay.
Of the church.
Mm-hmm.
We can look in the day now and see the church is dead.
Yes.
They closed.
Uh-huh.
We are the church. My body is the temple of God.
Yeah.
Meats are for the belly and bellies for the meat, but the body is made for the Lord.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So when I bring my body, temple of God house, His presence here.
Come on.
I'm not worried about COVID-19. I'm not worried about no virus coming up in God's house His presence is.
He's able.
He's able. I believe God. I believe the word of God. Now, here go a prophecy. He finna ask Bishop.
Can I say something?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it amazing how we can believe the hospitals can cure us? We can go to the soothsayer, the sorcery, the witch doctor, and the voodoo man and have confidence. But we're not talking about that now. We're talking about the sovereign God.
Mm-hmm.
We don't believe God can do what He said.
If the church believed
God would do what He said, then why aren't we flooding the house of God?
Okay, is God pleased right now?
No.
Because without faith,
it's impossible.
It's impossible to believe it. And He has no pleasure in them when they draw back.
That's right.
So I must keep my confession clean, because God is asking me. I feel like God is talking to me right here.
Amen.
I took this personal.
Me too.
at Bishop, it says here from the King James, the hand of the Lord was upon me.
Uh-huh.
The Spirit of the Lord was upon you,
uh-huh.
was upon Greater Trinity, mm-hmm. upon Franklin Powerhouse.
Jesus.
And carried
yes.
us out. Can I read it that way?
Uh-huh.
In the
yes,
Spirit
yes,
of the Lord.
Yes.
And uh-huh. set us down.
Down. Come on here.
In the midst of the valley, which was full of bones.
Mm-hmm.
And caused us to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley,
uh-huh.
and lo, they were very,
very
dry.
Very,
on
very.
Sundays, how dry do it be? I see this. God is showing us. He's asking us.
Yeah.
I want you to pick it up right there. I'm gonna let Apostle have it after you get through reading on now.
Let's see. You
we
went to
at,
three.
Yeah.
You
stopped
you
at two.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
Verse number three says, "And he said to me, Son of man, can these bones live?" And I answered, "O Lord God, you know."
You know.
Can I interject? Say, yes. Can something dead, can it live again?
Come on.
That's what I'm hearing.
So, can I go back up?
Yeah.
I like the way you did it. So, every leader, it doesn't matter what COVID is doing, if the hand of the Lord is upon you, he brought you out in the Spirit to the sanctuary that was dedicated to him and set you down in the middle of COVID.
Okay.
And there were many. So if God allows the Spirit to bring you to a place of sickness,
uh-huh.
you ought to be bold enough to stand and declare the word of the Lord
yeah.
to the weak and the feeble.
Okay, going right back
my
over
God.
Here to 34. You have not healed. You have not strengthened. And so God, ooh, glory to God.
Oh, my God.
And look at what he says now.
Yeah.
He didn't say the bone was just dry.
No, he said
they were dead. Very. So in other words, these bones was in bad shape.
Mm-hmm.
Very bad shape. So can something have, if died, can it live again?
And look at what, why is it God going to ask Ezekiel what he already know?
Okay.
He wanted Ezekiel to have enough confidence in him to say, yes, Lord, if you said it.
Yes, yes.
So when you have faith in God's word and you release that word up to a place now, if you don't do it, your name is on the line. I'm not finna stay up all night wondering if God gonna do it. Yeah. I caught the fig tree. Peter uh-huh. went by that. Wait a minute, Jesus, hold up. You spoke to this tree yesterday and it's dried up now.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
He said, if you had a God kind of faith, you can say to this mountain and have the same, you can get the same results.
Yeah.
Right.
So,
yeah.
so let's keep reading here.
I answered, O Lord God, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Again, he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord.
Stop right there. Don't hear propaganda.
Right.
Don't hear black history.
Come on.
Don't get up and preach civil rights.
Come on.
Because we bring all that to God house.
Come on.
We bring everything but what need to be here. Now, don't get wrong with making points about Philemon. I know I done heard that preached. Mm-hmm. A lot of things. But I'm talking about the word. What did he say?
Right here.
What did he say, Bishop?
Thus saith the Lord. Oh, no, no. Yet he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, O dry bone, hear the word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord. Can Jesus. They hear? If they hear, something gonna happen.
So, Apostle, I just looked at this. So, God asked Ezekiel a question. Ezekiel tell God, you know, God said, now say something.
Uh-oh. What you, okay. Apostle, what you gonna say?
Well, let me just flip back here for a minute.
Come on.
Job 14 and 4. He said, if a man die,
can he live again?
Shall he live again? That was thrown out there.
Okay.
But when we looked at Ezekiel 36, the latter part where a bishop read, and as he entered into 37, we're looking at a people that had rejected God. A people that had turned away from God, people that had, God had warned through the prophets about their wickedness and their ways of living, and turn unto me. But they killed the prophets, and they stoned the prophets. Yeah, yeah. And then when God scattered them, he told them and warned them that he would do it. He scattered them into the winds of the earth. Mm-hmm. And everywhere they went, they did the same thing. They profaned his name. And they were looked upon as less than nothing by the nation, even the heathen nation.
Okay.
When the Babylonians captured Israel and carried them off and set them down in Babylon, and they sat there, they first were dry. They sat there in their state. They were dry.
Okay.
The priest, they stayed there so long till the priest stopped preaching. The singers stopped singing.
Uh-huh.
The singers hung their musical instruments on the willows and on the walls. And when they was asked to sing a Zion song, they said, how can we sing the Lord's song down here in a strange land? Now, in their situation went from dry to very dry. And their state was as so bad. But God always, he looks up on us, he warns us,
yep,
and then he punishes us.
Yes.
But the love of God is extended. He said, I have stretched forth my hand all the day long.
And no man with God.
That's right. And when
God
did this for Israel, and he saw their condition, and he said, he spoke to Ezekiel. The Spirit of the Lord was upon him and carried him out in the midst of a valley,
yes, sir,
full of dead men's bones. Hallelujah. And he asked him a question. He sat him down in the midst.
In the midst.
And he said, son of man.
Why the middle? Because you can look at everything in the center.
In the center, you can look at everything. You can see everything. You can see the whole situation. It was dry. He saw that it was dry and very dry. And then the physical state, where Ezekiel was sitting in the valley, some theologians said was the valley of Jehoshaphat, where he had fought battles and men were killed, and their bones and their bodies, dead bodies, laid and scattered in the open valley in a physical state. But the situation had become so dry and laid there so long until the flesh went from the bone. And the bones were turning to powder, and the wind blew the dust down the valley.
Okay.
And that situation was very dry. I'm finna wrap this up.
No.
The situation was very dry. And the Lord spoke.
Come on.
You know, like right now, in the midst of COVID-19, in the midst of the church crying out, but the church still hadn't gotten it yet. They still thinking that. They're still looking to the government. They're looking to President Trump.
Right.
They're looking to the scientific field and the world.
Right.
They're looking all directions to all of these folks, thinking that they're coming up with a solution that's going to ease their load. But let me tell you something, to the church of the living God, hallelujah, we're going to have to come out of hiding. We're going to have to come front and center and get on our face before God and repent, come together with brothers like us that are standing, because we are not trying to put anybody down, but we're just not trying to keep you from dragging us down.
That's
we're
right.
not going to let you drag us down.
Amen.
In a hole.
Amen.
Running from God.
Amen.
When the case gets serious, we got to run to him.
Amen.
Right, and we are calling on him right now.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Let me say this. I got to let it go, because I've been there. Something to happen here.
Come on.
Down in that valley, the Lord says, son of man, can these bones live? He said, Lord, you know whether or not they can live.
Amen.
He said, prophesy, preach.
Come on.
To these bones.
Wait a minute. Why preaching?
Preaching. Listen.
Why preaching?
Preaching is the answer.
Can you get the church? Can you say that to the audience?
Preaching is the answer. The unadulterated word of God. I'm not talking about a watered-down gospel.
Come on.
I'm not talking about a sugar-coated gospel. I'm not talking about a gospel that would appease people. I'm not talking about that kind of gospel. I'm talking about the true, unadulterated word of God. He said, prophesy, preach to these dry bones. Preach. You know what? I go places and preach that sermon, people draw up. Because they think and they say, well, he talking about me? Yes.
Amen.
I am talking about you. If you're dry and very dry, I'm talking about you. But you got to do something about this situation. But when he said prophesy to the bone, he said, oh, ye dry bone. Let me stop there.
So.
Yes.
Apostle, you want to go?
Go ahead.
So I heard you, Apostle Wash. And I want to go back because you began to talk about in the middle of the valley, in the low place.
Oh, God.
COVID-19 has brought every leader to a low place.
Oh, God.
Come on.
But we hadn't prophesied the word of the Lord. We act like God only moves on the mountain.
Come on here,
right?
Come on.
I serve a God that moves on the mountain and in the valley.
And in the valley.
Of the shadow of death.
And even in the valley, valley experience, God says something is going on, and I need you to talk about my name now.
Okay.
Because, see, when we up on the mountaintop, we let everything go on. But when we hit the valley, the low place,
all right,
we feel like we done fell from grace. God said, now I got the church where I want them.
Okay.
I got them in the midst of a pandemic, and they can't handle it.
Amen.
Oh, God.
Amen. Yes. And that's true.
Yes.
So with that, he said, hear the words of the Lord.
Mm.
Hear God's word.
Hear God.
Because my word is spirit.
Uh-huh.
And it is life.
Yes.
So now with that being said, thus says the Lord in 5, the Lord God, thus says the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I cause breath. This is what he told them to preach.
Oh, God.
Yep.
He told them to preach. I cause breath to enter into you and ye shall live. This same breath that God put in Adam.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This is the same breath.
Mm.
I will lay sinew upon you and bring flesh upon you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is spiritual right here.
Yes.
God is prophesying a rebirthing of the church.
Yes, sir.
A revival is taking place right here.
Oh, God.
In the midst of all this deadness.
What did you say? A revival?
Not an empowerment.
Come on.
A revival. Something died.
Yes, yes.
So we know something died can be resurrected again.
Right.
Jesus told them Lazarus dead, but not.
He's sleeping.
He's sleeping. They said, well, Lord, we'll do good if we go and wake him. He said, I'm glad for your sake. We wasn't there. He said, he's dead. He plainly told him. But anyway, Bishop, we want you to pick back up and begin to read down here. I will lay sinew. 6.
Okay. I will put sinew on you, make flesh grow back on you, cover you with skin, and I will put breath in you so that you may come alive.
Oh, God.
And you will know that I am the Lord.
Stop. After this COVID, after the church get rebirthed, we going to know without a shadow of a doubt it is the Lord doing.
Yes.
And it's going to be marvelous in our eyes.
Yes, right. Yes.
God hit me with something when y'all was talking. He showed me a vision. We had a lot of people.
My God.
And we were putting.
Yes.
Chairs out.
Yes, God.
I had a vision early one morning before I got to church.
Mm-hmm.
The people that was the leaders I had.
Mm-hmm.
One was facing the wall, just kept bumping the wall. One was spinning around in circles. He said, look what's following you. Mm-hmm. He showed me. When I looked around, nobody
God
was following me.
Yes.
And I came to the, I called a meeting. Say, I knew y'all had some issues, but now God done showed me. I said, right now I don't have any leaders.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
I said, yes. I'm through with that. I mean, it hurt it.
Uh-huh.
Because I was like in my 19 years here. Mm-hmm. And still had nobody who could follow as I was following the Lord. That hurt me, but I'm glad he showed it to me.
Yes.
It showed me. So God is going to show us what we need to do to bring life and to get the people to know that he is the Lord.
Yes.
So,
Apostle, can I go back to something?
Yes, sir.
Even though God allowed Israel to go into captivity for their obedience, isn't the church in captivity now?
Yes.
Okay, but if you notice, when Israel repented and called, he answered.
Right.
So when the church repents, ain't nobody, the teaching priests ain't teaching the people to repent. They teaching them to hide. We got to bring the people to repentance. And God's going to say something.
When the churches and not putting anybody down, when they're saying it's okay, God's grace is sufficient. He know you're going to sin. God loves you. It's okay. and I think that's a false watered down part of it, because when you got people telling you that, don't you know God is listening to that?
Absolutely.
And don't you know, be not deceived, God is not mocked. That whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Yes.
I'm telling you, I'm afraid, because God's grace is his ability.
Yes.
When I prayed about an issue in my life, God said, son, go to bed. My grace. What he was telling me, my ability, my power.
Yep. Yes, it's able.
Is able to, and you know what? He didn't move it.
Mm-hmm.
But he taught me how to overcome that
thing. Yes,
so
yes,
he did not move it, but he said my power was there. So I stepped up and received what was available for me to be an overcomer.
My God.
So I've been redeemed.
Wow.
So with that being said, Satan was the reason for redemption. Mm-hmm. There could be no redemption without defeating Satan. So why am I afraid when Satan been defeated? If Jesus hadn't defeated Lucifer, I mean Satan, there would be no redemption.
It wouldn't be.
That is 100% true.
Right.
If you look at Colossians 2 and 15. I love that.
I got you right here. I got that verse right here.
I love that. I love that. And see, the church, you just got to saying it, but I just feel like we need to emphasize on it because of what Christ did for us at Calvary and the victory that has already been won. We're not fighting to win a victory.
No.
The victory has already been won. COVID-19 have already been defeated.
Why can't the church believe that?
The church can't believe it because the church is following the world. The church is sitting back, and the mega ministry, which I cried and hurt me so bad to see this happening. And these leaders and our leaders here in the state of Mississippi and our churches, hallelujah, are sitting back behind talking about I'm following some kind of guideline. You can't be crazy. You gotta keep yourself safe. I understand that.
Right.
But the house of God must come open, and the men of women of God got to stand in the pulpit. And regardless, whoever come, let them come by faith. The word of God said the just shall live by faith.
Amen.
Let them come by faith. If you don't have enough faith to come, then you stay at the house.
Amen.
But they that come in the house of God by faith, God is going to keep them. God is going
to
do it.
Bishop, Apostle wanted you to read. You wanted them to read.
Yes, sir.
Colossians 2 and 15. I can read it. It don't matter.
From the Amplified.
Yeah, you can read it. Yes, sir.
I
got 15 on the King James. And having spoiled principalities and powers.
Jesus.
He made a show of them openly. Triumphing over them.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So right there is victory in our life, in our earth walk, because Jesus had victory in his earth walk life.
Yes.
We can now, you can't tell me you can't live right Jesus won the right for you to live right because he lived right.
Right.
That anointing, that victory belongs to you, Apostle. It belongs to you, and it certainly belongs to me. So I got victory in my earth walk because Jesus gave me the victory. I can live right.
Hallelujah.
Jesus overcame that right here.
Glory to God.
So with that, go ahead.
Jesus. When he had disarmed the rulers and authority, those supernatural forces of evil operating against us.
Yes.
He made a public example of them, exhibiting them as captives in his triumphant possession.
Yes, procession.
Yes.
Having triumphed over them through the cross.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Through the redemption.
Through the cross.
The power that is redemption. When we go out against a demon, this is why I'm not scared of no
demon. Yeah, God. Yes,
Satan ain't got to deal with Cliff.
Come on.
He's dealing with the third person of the Trinity. I know this. When I step up, Satan ain't looking at me. He's looking at the third person of the Trinity.
My God.
This is why we got the enemy. The enemy is sitting back laughing. Uh-huh. Black and white. Black Lives Matter. Satan laughing, picking his teeth, and they don't recognize it's him and it's he's a murderer from the beginning. His spirit is in these folk killing one another. And they talk about black and white. And Satan said, no, this is a spiritual issue. It's not a black and white issue. Right, I'm behind it. Right. But we get mad at people. And I tell the saints all the time, quit looking at your brother and look behind your brother. Deal with the enemy.
Yes.
Find out what spirit that is and deal with it. Don't get mad with your brother or sister. Because they didn't do it. They were used.
Right.
They can be manipulated. That's what we got going on now. So Satan is laughing at the church because everybody in the uproar with this racist stuff, and they ain't located him not yet. So Bishop, what you just read has put in redemption. That's victory in our redemption.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
What he did at the cross, let me say this quickly. What he did at the cross, when he died on Calvary, the veil of the temple, it rent from the top to bottom.
Okay.
And now he gave us the victory as we just got to reading. He triumphed over all, he disarmed all of the powers of darkness, all diseases.
How did Jesus get that done?
By his death on the cross and his death, burial, and resurrection.
The sacrifice caused all that to become to us.
Yep. Yeah, yeah.
So victory in sacrifice. There's victory in a sacrifice.
Right.
Tell me, now, I'm, what sacrifice you didn't make and didn't get a victory behind it? What sacrifice you didn't make for God and didn't get victory?
When I make a sacrifice, God, when I go to God, but I make a sacrifice, God always answers. God always show up. He'll always show up. He never failed me yet.
If it's fasting.
Come over here.
If it's giving up, whatever you decide to make a sacrifice to God and you present it to him, he honors that.
Right.
Tell me you don't get victory. What if it's a certain area in your life that you sacrifice something in?
But nobody want to hear that.
But we go all the way back. Bishop, we go back to what Apostle said earlier concerning, one of y'all said, concerning do the church really believe that God is God?
No.
Do the church really believe that salvation is in him? And that he died on the cross for us. If the church don't believe that, then they got a right to be fearful.
Yes, they do, as long as they don't have to face a trial.
Okay.
God expects victory out of you.
God
is expecting victory. Look at what he has invested in you. Look at what he has invested in you. Look at what he has invested in me. And we can't get victory. We can't experience the victory. Christ done already laid this thing
already
out.
Laid
the
it
Holy
out.
Spirit in Christ helped him to lay that sacrifice out, raise him from the dead.
Yes.
And now the same anointing that is in us can lead us to the same victory after victory.
Woo.
After victory. And God is expecting the same results his son got.
So that's why I said, long as the church don't have to face a trial or a test,
mm-hmm. Okay. Well,
once the trial, the test come, it's then, like we retreat.
Okay.
Well, now you know what you really know.
Right.
The test, okay, you do a year of study in school. What school did you go to? And the teacher just, you went chapter after chapter after chapter, at the end of the year came. All right, y'all passed, no test came.
You got a test.
You mean to tell me test came after every chapter?
Test.
Listen, y'all talking to something that really would make me want to shout
come on,
here.
Come on.
But in 1 Peter 1 and 7, that the trials of your faith, being more precious than gold that perish, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearance of Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, I'm going up with Christ or down. Whatever way he allowed me to go, that way I'm going. But my trust is going to be in him. I'm trusting God for everything.
Amen.
I'm trusting God for everything.
Let me say this, Bishop. I'm going to let you go. God told Joshua, and this just jumped in my spirit. He said, my servant Moses is dead. And as I was with Moses, so I'm going to be with you. I have given you the land. Uh-huh. But he told them the land was there in the mm-hmm. beginning. Uh-huh. But he told them how to go in there. Uh-huh. He said, it's yours. God is saying we got authority over Corona. God has told us that through his word.
You know,
he's told, wait a minute, I'm giving you, didn't even go back. You know that what the word uh-huh. said. He told Joshua, I have given. God, man, this thing is done. But Bishop said it. Now the test come, we in retreat when we can walk above the new creation in me. Cliff can't do nothing, but this born again joke inside of me can handle Corona.
I may need to hurry, but listen.
I'm sorry, I'm right.
Listen. When you did this to me, when God said, I gave you the land.
I gave
it to you.
You didn't earn it. I
gave it to you. But in order for you to possess it, then you got to fight on your hands.
You got to show up.
You got to show up. You got opposition. You got the ikes in the land that is going to oppose you.
Come on.
But I give it to you. It's yours. All you got to do is take a stand. I'm going to be with you. I'm going to fight for you.
Do you see that?
All you got to do is take a stand. But when the Joker went up there and spied the land out, ten of them came back and said, there are giants in the land. They got fortified cities. And when we looked at them, we were grasshoppers in our own eyes.
So the men of God, the shepherds, the under-shepherds, hadn't been feeding the faith word to get the people up to see beyond them to look at who is the greater one over COVID. Over anything. So
Joshua and Caleb, I'm a hurt.
Feed what you have been eating.
Joshua and Caleb, these are preachers that preaching the word.
Come on now.
They come back and say, we are more than able. We are more than able to conquer the land. They were the only two that was able to see it from God's eye.
Whoa. The ratio between unbelief and belief is like this.
Oh, yeah. My God.
But yeah. God loves to be on the opposite side where there's less at. Because uh-huh. he'll show the bigger crowd, the one that's all together. Why do people think when it's the bigger crowd going against, they
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm. Well, they're trying to tell us. The pastor's trying to tell us, even right now.
We wrong.
That we are wrong.
That's why.
They're trying to tell us. Hallelujah, that we are crazy. They're trying to tell us that we are radicals.
I lost my mind.
We have lost our mind.
I have the mind of
They're
Christ.
Trying to tell us that God ain't that kind of God.
What?
God will not protect you like that. You are tempting God. And when God has already told us, and he called us, and he placed us in a house, and our job is to stand and preach the unadulterated word of God, and I'm sitting at the house on my living room couch watching TV and tell my watch me on Facebook, The devil is a lie, friend. You got to come out of your house and go to the house of God. And I'm not afraid to say it. And I've been saying it.
Keep saying it.
I've been saying it. These men been saying
I'm
it.
Keep saying
I thank God for them. I got somebody to talk to. And so, you know, while the other folks ain't going to talk to them, they'll hang the phone up. They won't even answer the phone.
Amen.
But I call these brothers. They'll talk to me.
We're going to get in the word.
You know,
go
so
ahead, Bishop.
I think a lot of times people say that God won't do that. God ain't going to protect you. You got to have sense. You don't know God to that capacity.
Brother, that's good.
I high five you in the spirit.
That's good.
I would never say what God won't do.
Man.
When you say God said. I got some respect because I know your character. I know your character. If you say God said, I'm believing it because I know if you don't, they
same
may
here.
Not know God like you know
same
God.
Here.
Can I say something? I want to go back to Gideon and Judges. Gideon chose 32,000 men to go to war.
Exactly.
And God looks at him and says, them you got is too many.
Too many. Too many. Yes.
So
yes.
Gideon went back and told him, say, everybody that's afraid, go home.
Go home.
22,000 left.
Yes.
Then he go back to God again. God said, that you got now is too many.
Too many.
Bring them to the brook. Let me try them for you.
Okay. Yes.
And so when God got through, he had 300 men.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He had less than 1%.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
But God said, I've already given them into your hands.
Yes.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
No, he didn't go ahead on and give a word and say, I have given this over into your hands.
Come
I've
on
given
here.
This into your hands.
Abraham said, if I in the sacrifice, if I kill it, God is able to raise him from the dead.
God has given COVID-19 in the hands of the preachers and the men and the women of God. We got to take that stand and come together. We cannot hide. We can't fight from a hiding in a foxhole. We got to come out the foxhole and we got to fight and face the enemy. We got to come out because the victory have already been won. I heard the Lord said, Jehoshaphat, you won't even have to fight in this battle.
Okay.
The battle is mine. You show up. The battle is mine. If you show up, but don't hide, come to your place.
Okay, we got 4 minutes. That's good. But Bishop, Hebrews 2:14-18. You write that down, and that's a good verse dealing with Colossians 2:15. So with the redemption that is in the New Testament church, God said, now my body going to be spiritual. Hebrews 2:14-18. God is saying now, upon this statement of truth, Peter, I'm going to build my church on revelation knowledge. What you said, I am the Son of God. Only my Father revealed that. So I'm building my church on truth.
Mm-hmm.
On this statement, Peter. Peter made a statement and he said something that was concrete that nobody else got.
Come out here.
So we know I got victory because Christ had victory. I got victory over COVID.
Yes.
I believe it. And I'm not crazy. God has given me a word. He told them to preach the word and watch this church come alive.
Yes.
The remnant is small. I heard you, Bishop.
Yeah.
I heard you, Apostle. Ain't many standing.
My God.
The remnant is small.
It's small.
Yes. Yes.
And they'll never say, we ain't a part of it.
Come on.
Oh, yeah, we in this too. Well, where you at?
Come on.
You can't count which don't show up.
Yes, yes.
You got to show up to be counted.
Yes, yes.
I'm on my post.
Come on.
You
here.
On your post.
Yes, yes. Yes.
You on your post.
I'm on it.
God didn't ever tell me to get off the post.
That's right.
So
that's right.
So with that being said, what do that say? Did you flip over there real quick?
I will.
We're going to go out with this one. Saints of God, I know you've been being blessed. I know you've been hearing
my
something.
God.
If you a child of God and your church is not open, it's other church. I'm not telling you to go there and join, but you need some word.
Mm-hmm.
You need to be cared for. Go ahead.
Hebrews 2:14 says, therefore, since these his children share in flesh and blood the physical nature of mankind, he himself in a similar manner also shared in the same physical nature, but without sin.
Okay, come on.
So that through experiencing death, he might make powerless, ineffective, impotent him who had the power of death, that is the devil.
Oh my God. He kicked the devil butt.
Yes,
we
yes.
got authority over. Now we run roughshod over the devil. The new creation is able to handle a defeated foe.
The honor is the expectation of the creature. Wait is on the manifestation of the sons of God. We got to rise up and come to our position.
With that, the earth waiting to see the manifestation of the sons and daughters of God.
That's right.
And we ain't hiding.
Oh,
no, we ain't hiding. Bishop, thank you. It's time to close out.
Yeah.
Thank God for you. I'm fired up, keyed up. Jesus, the victory he won over Satan is the victory I enjoy.
Yeah.
Over flu.
Yeah.
Over stomach virus,
yeah.
Over cancer,
yes.
Over AIDS, over all the things that's been healed in Bishop ministry and apostle
yes.
ministry
yes.
and our ministry.
Thank
yes.
you, Lord.
Yes.
The Lord is able to keep
God.
The church.
Yes. Yes.
It's his
yes.
church.
Yes.
It's not our church.
Yes.
These are not our people because the people is the church.
That's right.
So we don't have a church. We don't own people. But we know God is able because of what he has done in our lives.
Yes. yes.
He
yes.
saved me from myself. I know he can save me from COVID.
Yeah.
Saints of God, we thank God. Apostle
yes.
Clarence Walsh, we thank
you.
God for
bless
you.
Yourself.
We are out of time, but we're not out of word. Until next time, pass this word along. In Jesus' name, be blessed. My-